What's going on, my PT peeps? I'm Walking Dead family, my fighters. I'm One Eye Bri, also known as PT. Don't know if I'm Wiccan or Blanca, but I'm definitely thinking about The Walking Dead is back, and I'm excited. You're excited. Season 10, episode 17 airs today for a lot of people around the world, probably tomorrow for some people. Now, it was technically back last week for early access. I'm going to talk about the episode a little bit. Spoiler warning for all things Walking Dead, but definitely for season 10, episode 16 and 17, spoiler warning. I have to say, if you saw the episode or not, it's just good that The Walking Dead is back. Remember when we saw season 10, episode 16? We had to wait forever, like months and months and months to watch one episode. And then luckily, we got six extra episodes for season 10. And I really hope season 10, episode 22, which I guess is the actual season finale, is better than season 10, episode 16. Don't get me wrong. There was good moments, there was good things, but they were building it up with a big battle and a big thing, and it was going to be some big battle Game of Thrones style, and Beta and burnt, gone. That was it? Daryl, Beta, Negan, that was the fight scene? Well, either way, it came and went, and the Whisper War was over. We saw Maggie, Elijah, well, we didn't know his name at the time, but it's Elijah. You get to see a little bit more about that character in season 10, episode 17. He's actually unmasked. Then we saw Connie in season 10, episode 16. And we're like, great, she's still alive. Virgil found her. What's going to happen there? She's not in season 10, episode 17, even though she's mentioned. Now, we will see Maggie in the opening minutes taking out this Whisper walker. Well, the walker that was a Whisper. You can see the arrow in the back of the Whisper that died and became a walker. You'll see Judith and Maggie have some dialogue. And then it's all good. And it's a good conversation. You see Lydia, Nabila, and then it gets awkward. Negan and Maggie come face to face. They see each other. And to be honest, it's kind of a letdown because Maggie doesn't say anything. There's some awkward moments where Judith's like, what do I do? What do I say? I don't know what to do, right? You're like, I'm just gonna stay out of it. But Maggie leaves. She doesn't say anything. She doesn't do anything besides excuse herself from the conversation and the interaction. And I have to say that she carries the bow the entire episode and she doesn't fire one arrow. I could be wrong, but I don't think she does, right? You see Daryl and Carol, and of course, they're a big part of the episode. They're going to be a big part of these six extra episodes and season 11 and the spinoffs. The big part of the series still. We get to meet Elijah and Cole, her people. Maggie likes to find people, evidently. Like, a lot of people are attracted to Maggie. Hilltop, these two, among others. Carol spills the beans about Negan and Hilltop, and she takes him there. But I want to say, like, I'm glad there was more people in the episode than I thought. And remember, this was filmed during a pandemic. And it's not the best episode, but it's a good episode. It's a good start. And I don't think you would really know that it was filmed in a pandemic. Kelly's looking for Connie. And there's definitely some Easter eggs that I'm going to have in a separate video. We break some things down. This is kind of one of them right here. But Kelly is a character that I think should expand her story. Maybe in the six extra episodes, but probably into season 11. I would assume that these six extra episodes are going to be like this group in one episode, that group in another, that group in another, the Negan episode, the Aaron and Father Gabriel episode. This was the Maggie return episode. So they're going to break it up a little bit. But what do you feel about these new characters? Do you like Elijah and Cole? I mean, Elijah's the strong, silent type, the one with the mask on. And Cole could be the new romance for Maggie. But I did like the interaction with Daryl and Cole. Like, yeah, we're trying to figure stuff out. Relax, buddy. You're new here. Don't overstep your boundaries, Cole, right? I want to see their interaction. Cole needs to kind of run his mouth and get put in his place. I kind of want to see Cole and Negan maybe have a little fight. That'd be pretty cool. But Maggie returned, and that's the big part of this episode. Maggie is back. And some people on Facebook are like, I hate Maggie and her stupid hat. Not me, just people on Facebook. I was like, whoa, right? And all these bodies and everything, this is still the aftermath of the Whisper of War and them burning Hilltop. The bodies, the barricades, just the remnants of the battle and the war at Hilltop. Again, I asked the question in other videos, do you think they rebuild Hilltop in season 11? I think so. Maggie's back and we found out kind of where she was. She went to Knoxville, Tennessee. Georgie was involved, but Georgie went west. So is Georgie connected with the Commonwealth, the Civic Republic? Nothing. Will we see her again? We saw Elijah. He didn't speak at all. He lost a sister, kind of like Kelly has, even though Connie's alive. They don't know that yet. So they still have to find her. I don't think we'll see Connie until season 11. But they're building for things. They're kind of bridging the gap between season 10, episode 16, and season 11. Like where they were, where they're going, and then where they eventually go in season 11. It's kind of cool. Overall, it definitely has that Predator feel. I talked about that in my first review. Just listen to the music, the episode, and it definitely reminds me of another episode that I'll talk about in the Easter egg video that I'll post next week. And I have to say, I watched the episode early. I've actually watched it twice. And it's kind of been tough to not post a bunch of things because I want to talk about the episode so much, but so many people haven't seen the episode, and that's okay. But after today, we're going to talk about it, break it down. Next week, we're going to talk about the episode a bunch more, and then season 10, episode 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, and it's going to happen like that. It's going to be over, and then we'll have Fear of the Walking Dead, then the summer, and then maybe The Walking Dead season 11, part A, and then World Beyond. I don't know what their plan is yet, but I have to say that season 10, episode 17 was a good start for the 6 extra episodes. Yeah, it could have been better, as people said it was boring and it was this and it was trash. Not me, I'm not saying that. I'm just quoting what other people are saying, but overall I was excited that The Walking Dead was back, and overall it was a good episode. It did have the feel of The Walking Dead. I wasn't like, what is this show? What are they doing, right? We did meet some new characters, and my question that should be answered in time, only time will tell, is why did they come about? To help fight the Commonwealth or the Civic Republic? Why did Maggie bring these people back? Because she couldn't survive on her own? Or are they to replace, like, Jesus? Like, is Cole Jesus 2.0 and Elijah is the martial artist with weapons? Because if you follow the comic, Jesus and Michonne should still be alive on the show, and so should Rick and Carl, of course. But the Negan-Maggie dynamic had its initial start. They saw each other. Negan's a free man. Maggie's not gonna like that. They both live in Alexandria. They're rebuilding parts of Alexandria. The Whispers left them a present. Did they burn up the place? Did they do some damage that they can't fix for a while, if at all? But Maggie, Herschel, they're back inside Alexandria to live among everybody. How's it gonna go down? Can't wait to find out. And like I said before, overall, I'm excited The Walking Dead is back because, again, we probably shouldn't have these episodes. But AMC, the writers, Angela Kang, everybody involved, they wanted to have these 6 extra episodes to put something out because they like to have episodes come out every February and October. And that's what we got. We got 6 episodes, which is better than nothing. Let me know your thoughts. Post your comments below. And this week, we're going to break down the episode much more in detail. We're going to talk about Easter eggs and things. I'm very excited to talk about it. Thank you, guys. Let me know your thoughts. Post your comments below. Stay safe. And as always, tell them, Daryl.